All right, guys, so this should be the last video in this section in the in the profile routes. What we want to do is we want to be able to delete an experience and an education, okay? And the user will be able to do this from their dashboard on the front end. So let's create a new route here. We'll grab one of these. Actually, we'll grab this whole thing because it's going to be a protected route, so we need our little piece of middleware. All right, so this will be, this is going to be a delete request. I think this is the first delete request that we've done. It's going to be API profile. Let's do experience first. And it's going to be, we need the ID of the experience. Remember, we saw that when it's created, it actually creates an ID on its own. So we want the exp ID. And then we'll say delete experience from profile private route. And let's change the URL here to experience slash colon exp underscore ID. All right, we want the passport authenticate. We want all that. We don't need this error checking. And then we also want to get rid of the find one, which ends right here. Actually, you know what? That's not right. We do want the find one because we want to find the user first. So we're going to find it by request.user.id. It's going to give us our profile, but we can get rid of this. Get rid of all that. So what do we want to do in here? We want to basically find the experience that we want to delete. Okay, so let's say get remove index. And there's a few ways to do this with JavaScript. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use map and I'm going to use index of. So we're going to say const, we're going to create a variable called remove index. We're going to set that to profile. Remember, we have access to the profile experience, which is an array. And then we're going to use the higher order method map, okay, which basically allows you to map an array to something else. What we're going to do is take the item and map it to an array of item IDs. So we just have the IDs. Then we're going to call dot index of. And in here, we want to match whatever's passed in here. And we can access that with request.params.exp underscore ID. Okay, so that will actually get us the correct experience to delete. All right, now that just gets it. Once we have it, we want to splice it. We'll say splice out of array. So we'll say profile.experience, which is the array. And then we want to do dot splice, pass in the remove index, okay, because now we know which one we want to remove, and we want to remove just one from that index. And then we can save. So we can resave it by saying profile.save dot then. And let's pass in here. It'll give us our profile back, our updated profile, and then we just want to send that back. Okay, that should be it. Let's just add a catch on here as well. And we'll just do res.status. It's going to be a 404.json. We'll just pass in the error. All right, so that should delete it, hopefully. Let's save. And let's go back to Postman. And I don't want to delete the experience I added because I want to keep that there. So what I'll do is add another one. So I'm just going to change this to a post request to experience. And let's just change, what do we have for experience? We had title. I'll just say test. Another required field was company. And then we had from, so let's get rid of field of study. We don't want that. We can get rid of description. So this should actually be enough to actually add an experience. So let's try it. And if we look in our experience array, we now have that test experience. So now we want to delete it. So what I'll do is open up another tab, make a delete request. Localhost 5000 API/experience. Okay, remember it's a delete request this time. We need our authorization. So we'll grab that from here. And we shouldn't need to send, oh yeah, we need the ID of the experience. So if we look at the experience we want to delete, it's this one here. So I'm going to grab this ID, copy that, and put that in here like that. So yeah, let's run that. Cannot delete experience. Cannot delete experience. Let's see. Oh, here's the problem right here. Router.post. It's not a post request, it's a delete. Let's try that. So click send again. Okay, so that still didn't work. We're getting the 404 not found. Oh, authorization should be here. Wait, what is going on? All right, let's grab, maybe we have to do the actual key first and then the value. Not sure why it's doing that. So we'll grab that, put that in there, and send. Okay, so we're still getting an error. Oh, we forgot profile. Profile/experience. There we go. So we get the profile back and look at experience. The test is now gone. So we're able to delete it. Good. So let's see. The next thing we want to do is we want to be able to do the same thing for education. And the logic is pretty much identical. So I'm going to copy the whole route we just did and change it to profile/education, and we'll say EDUID. We'll say delete education. So router.delete education slash EDUID, and we're going to do profile. All this stuff is the same. Remove index. We're going to use this in the same way. We just need the education array instead. We're going to map the item to the ID. We're going to find the index based on the param EDUID. Once we get that, we're going to say profile.education. We're going to splice out from, we're going to splice the remove index out, and then we're going to save the profile again and send it back. All right, so save that. And now let's try to first add a new piece of education that we can delete. So we're going to make our post request to API profile education. And let's go to our body and just change to this to school. Just say test, that's fine. School, we also want a degree. And what else? Field of study, I believe, is required. Okay, let's send that. And let's see if it got added, which it did right here. Let's grab the ID. And let's go back to the other tab where we did the delete for the experience. And let's change this to education slash and then that ID and send. All right, so we should have got the profile back, but we got an empty object. So let's see if it actually got deleted. So we can go to one of these routes. Let's see, do we have the handle one open? We have profile all, so I guess we can use that. So I'll send, and let's look at Brad's education, and it looks like the test is still there, so it didn't delete. So let's go back and see what happened here. It just returned an empty object, so. And here's my issue right here. Education was spelled wrong, so it didn't actually splice it out. So let's go ahead and save that. And hopefully that should work. So we'll go back to our delete education route. Let's send. And let's check education. And there we go. So now just the Northern Essex is there. The test one is gone. So now up to this point, we can add and remove education and experiences from our profile, which is great. Now, there is one more route that I want to create, and I don't want to make a whole separate video for it, so we'll just do it now. I want a route that will actually delete the user and the profile. Okay, so it's not going to be too difficult. Let's go right down here at the bottom, and this should be the last route we need in this file. So it'll be API delete request API slash profile. And we'll say delete user and profile. And let's see. Let's just copy this. So it'll be delete slash, which is API profile. Of course, it's protected. And then we're going to do, let's delete everything that's within the arrow function. And we're going to use profile dot find one and remove. Okay, so that's a mongoose method we can use. And then we're going to pass in here, we want to match the user to request.user.id, which is the current user. And that'll give us a promise, so we'll say dot then, and then in here we'll just do an arrow function, no parameters, and then we want to also delete the user. This will delete the profile, but I'm going to have it also delete the user. And if you wanted to do it differently, where it just delete the profile but it keeps the user in the collection, you could do that. But I'm going to delete the user as well, and let me just check to make sure. Yeah, I did. I brought in the user model. This should actually say model. And we'll go down here, and now we'll take the user and we'll call find one and remove, or find by, which was it? Find one and remove. Now, since this is the user's collection, we're not matching user, we're matching the ID itself, which is underscore ID. And we want to match that to request.user.id. And that'll give us a promise. And in here, all I'm going to do is res.json and just pass in. It doesn't matter what we pass in here. We don't need to return anything. Obviously, the profile's gone, the user's gone. So I'm just going to say success true and save. All right, so now let's create a new user and profile just to delete, because I want to keep the two we have. So I'll go to, let's see, this is the login. Let's change this to register. So post request to API users register. Let's add in the body, email. I'll say test at test.com. Let's make this one the name. And let's create password. Password 2. And let's try to register this user. We don't need any authorization. Okay, that's not there anyways. So let's register. Good, so now we have a registered user. Now we want to add a profile for this user. So we're going to have to log in so we can get the token. So let's go users slash login. and we'll get rid of password 2 and name. We just want the email and password to log in. We'll send. Okay, that works. We got our token. So I'll grab the token. And now we want to create a profile. So we want to go to API profile, just API profile, post request. And let's add our header, our authorization. Now you're kind of seeing the complete flow here. So we have our authorization, and then to create the profile, we need what? A handle. We'll just do the bare minimum here. So we need a handle. We'll just say test. We need what else? Status. And skills. Say HTML, CSS. Let's see if that works, if we can create a profile with that. And it did. So now we have our profile. Now if we go to, let's just check MongoDB real quick. So now we have three users and three profiles. We have Brad, John Doe, and we have the test user. Okay, so we want to delete the test user, which should delete the user and the profile. You can see we have his profile here as well, right here. So what we want to do here is make sure we're logged in as the test user, which we are because we have his token in the authorization. And then we're going to make a delete request to that API profile, and that should delete both, okay, user and profile. So let's give it a shot. Bam. Success true. Okay, so let's just double check. We'll go back to MongoDB. This is the, what is this, the profiles. Let's reload. That profile is now gone. And users, you can see now there's only two users and the test user is gone. So he's now able to delete his entire account, the profile and the user. All right, guys, so that is going to be it for this section. We've completed our profile routes. So in the next section, we're going to add our post routes and our post model and all that. And then we can finally move to the front end and start building our React application on top of our Express API.